Doctor, I've heard a lot of things, but I have a question about what actually causes attention deficit?
That's a good question, Kirk. And we've got some research that's giving us some answers to it. We still have a lot to learn about it, but we do have a pretty good idea of what's going on in the brain. I think I can probably explain it better if I draw a couple things up here on the flip chart. We know that ADHD is inherited, and we know that it responds to treatment with certain kinds of medication, but not with other kinds of medication in most cases. And if you picture the brain and think of it as a little bit bigger than a large grapefruit, in there you've got 100 billion neurons. Those are the cells that make up most of the brain. And they come in different sizes and shapes, but they all work on a branches and twig system like this. And the thing that's amazing about them is if you look at any one of them, it's going to be connected to over 1,000 others. But the thing that's amazing about it is it's not wired together. And if you look at the connections between these things, they all look like this. Like two mushroom heads butted up against each other with a space thinner than a piece of tissue paper in between. And the whole thing works on low voltage electrical current. You know, as a message comes along, and there's a constant flow of messages, these electrical impulses, low voltage electrical currents coming along here, has to jump this gap like a spark plug, hit a receptor button on the other side, and fires down in the next segment. And all of this is done quickly. In 1 millisecond, 1,000th of a second, you can get 12 messages across here. It's all done with chemicals. The brain makes 50 different chemicals, and each one of these neurons works on one of them. So whichever chemical this one's working on is going to be made in the brain. It's going to be located in little bubbles next to the edge. So when the electrical impulse comes, it releases micro dots of the chemical. That's what crosses the gap, hits the receptor, fires it to send the message on, and then the remainder of the chemical gets sucked back into the sending cell, and the system reloads in fractions of a second. And what we believe happens with people who have ADD is that there are two different neurotransmitter chemicals, dopamine and norepinephrine, that everybody has. People with ADD, their brains make them the same way everybody else's brain does, but they just don't release and reload effectively. And what we know is for about 80% of people who have ADHD, if you give them the right amount of the right medication, it helps to facilitate this. The medicines that we have right now cure nothing. It's not like you have a strep throat and it just knocks out the infection. You know, it's more like my glasses. I've got a problem with my eyes where I can't read typewriter-sized print without my glasses. If I put these on, I can read it about as well as anybody can. Take them off, I'm right back where I started from. The glasses don't fix my eyes, they just help me see better when I've got them in place. And the same thing is true for people who have ADHD. The medicine doesn't cure the problem, but it does help to alleviate the symptoms if it's properly managed and during the time when it's actually in place.